There's an interesting relationship between cortisol and vitamin D that I'm going to talk about today. Or I could also say there's an interesting relationship between stress and vitamin D as well. So the first question is this: is it the vitamin D that causes low cortisol? Or is it the cortisol, either too high or too low, that causes a vitamin D deficiency? Is it the chicken or the egg? Well, I think it's the chicken and the egg, because vitamin D is required to make adrenal hormones, not just the adrenal hormone cortisol, but other adrenal hormones as well. And so if a person is deficient in vitamin D, which includes the majority of the population, because most people have a vitamin D deficiency, then they're also going to be deficient in certain adrenal hormones, which can then set them up for all sorts of problems, not having enough adrenal support to counter stress in life. I mean, the adrenal hormones are all about adapting your physiology to the environment related to stress. And if you're not adapting to stress, you can have a lot of problems. And this is why there are so many diseases that are caused by stress. Ulcers, diabetes, increased risk for cancer, autoimmune disease, heart conditions, infection. There are so many people that end up with an infection, both viral and bacterial, which occurs right after a stress event, because the stress lowers the immune system and makes you very susceptible to getting an infection. Then you have insomnia, sleep apnea. It can affect your mood, put you in a state of anxiety or depression, and it can make you gain weight because cortisol affects the blood sugars. And then we have another aspect of this. Vitamin D and cortisol are both powerful anti-inflammatories. And so how many conditions out there are involved with inflammation? I mean, just about every single chronic health problem has an inflammatory factor to it. And then we have another situation where we have high cortisol, Cushing syndrome, and low cortisol, Addison's, both related to a vitamin D deficiency. Now, if we also look at the immune system, okay, cortisol normally suppresses the white blood cells, and vitamin D modulates the immune system, which means it helps control it. So if there is an overactive immune system, whether you have allergies, hypersensitivities, or even something severe like a cytokine storm, and vitamin D can come in there and help suppress the overreaction of the immune system. And related to that, vitamin D has a very important purpose of helping to prevent autoimmune diseases. So does cortisol, because if there's a problem with cortisol, that can set you up for a susceptibility to developing an autoimmune disease as well. And then we have the raw material that actually makes cortisol and vitamin D. It comes from the same thing, cholesterol. And so if you are on a statin drug or you're told to go on a low-fat diet and you don't have enough cholesterol to make both vitamin D and cortisol, and on top of that, bile. Bile is made from cholesterol as well. So if you don't have the raw material to make these, you can imagine what could happen to your immune system, inflammation, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. And so this cortisol and vitamin D relationship is very interesting. Any condition that involves cortisol, either too much or too little, I highly recommend you take vitamin D to help to normalize cortisol, because that will actually enhance it. In fact, I like looking at vitamin D as a natural prednisone without the side effects. In recent videos, I talked about the 10th cause of a vitamin D deficiency, which is polymorphism, which is kind of a defect in the vitamin D receptor. And you can watch that video, I'll put it down below. But I listed all the different causes of a vitamin D deficiency, and I added number 11, which is stress. So the more stress you go through, the more vitamin D you're going to be deficient. And so the bottom line is stress causes a vitamin D deficiency, and a vitamin D deficiency can also make you more stressed and create a cortisol problem. All right, thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Hey, before you go, if you're benefiting from any of my content, I would love to hear about your success story. Please share it in the link down below.